AMD's new Ryzen 5 5600X is an excellent processor, but how does it compare against the 3600 from last generation, and is it worth upgrading? I've compared games and applications to help you decide. This video is sponsored by Ridge Wallet. You probably never thought you'd ask for a wallet for Christmas, but this is one you'll want under your tree. It's light, sleek, and can hold up to 12 cards plus cash in over 30 different styles. Whether it's a gift for yourself or someone else, it's hard to go wrong with something built right. Ridge also offered the commuter backpack with a padded shock-resistant laptop compartment for carrying your tech. You can get 10% off with free worldwide shipping and returns by going to ridge.com/Jarrod. The link is in the description. Both processors have the same amount of cores, threads, cache, and TDP. The main difference is, of course, that the 3600X uses the newer Zen 3 architecture, and this allows it to reach higher base and boost clock speeds. However, this puts it at $100 more expensive than the 3600. You could argue that the 3600X would have made for a better comparison, but based on my 3600 vs 3600X comparison, they're basically the same and it generally wasn't worth paying more for the X. Unfortunately, there's no 5600 non-X at the time of launch, but if I had to guess, this will probably come later. So for now, I think comparing the 3600 against the 5600X is the way to go. Both processors were tested in the same system. I've tested with 32GB of DDR4 3200 memory running in dual channel at CL14, and with MSI's GeForce RTX 3090 Gaming X Trio graphics card to minimize bottlenecks. Although both processors come with a Wraith Stealth cooler in the box, I've tested using my Fractal S36 AIO with Noctua NT-H2 thermal paste, so I can compare my data with other chips. I've tested both CPUs at stock, and with the following all-core overclocks applied, so I was able to push the 5600X 500MHz higher than the 3600. But that said, my 3600 does seem to have lost the silicon lottery, as many others seem capable of 4.3 to 4.4 GHz. With that in mind, we'll first check out the differences in various applications, as well as power draw and thermals, followed by gaming tests afterwards, then finish up by comparing some performance per dollar metrics. Starting out with Cinebench R20, we can see the 5600X was scoring 24% higher in single core at stock, a huge improvement in just one generation. Likewise, the 5600X was also 20% faster in multi-core, again an amazing improvement in just over a year. When overclocked, the 3600 does worse in single core as the all-core overclock prevents single core boost going further, while the 5600X's overclock helped more. I've also tested the older Cinebench R15 as a lot of people still use it, so you can compare my results. The margins weren't too different to R20, so let's move on. I've tested Blender with the BMW and Classroom benchmarks. This test makes use of all cores. However, the improvements weren't as big as in Cinebench, with the 5600 completing the Classroom test 16% faster than the 3600 at stock, but then 18% faster once both are overclocked, as the 5600X is able to overclock better. The V-Ray benchmark is another core-heavy rendering workload. At stock, the 5600X was 22% faster than the 3600. Then with both overclocked, the 5600X is now 26% faster, again due to the superior overclocking headroom. The Corona benchmark also uses the processor to render out a scene, and the differences were very close to what we just saw in the V-Ray test. The 3600's overclock only improved the rendering time by 1 second, while the 5600X's overclock reduced total completion time by 4 seconds. Not a big change, but again, it helps outline the better overclocks Zen 3 is capable of. Handbrake was used to convert one of my 4K laptop review videos to 1080p. There was less of a difference here when compared to the other multi-core workloads tested, with the 5600X completing the export task just 9% faster at stock, then 13% faster with both overclocked. Adobe Premiere was used to export one of my laptop review videos at 4K. I've tested with both VBR 1-pass, which should make better use of hardware acceleration compared to 2-pass. There wasn't much difference between the two tests though. At stock, the 5600X was 14% faster than the 3600 in the 1-pass test, and 15% faster in the 2-pass export, rising up to 20% faster when both processors are overclocked. I've also tested Adobe Premiere, but with the Puget Systems benchmark tool, as this tests for more things like live playback rather than just raw export times. The 5600X was scoring 9% faster over the 3600 at stock, one of the lowest results out of the applications tested. Adobe Adobe Photoshop was also tested with the Puget Systems benchmark tool. This test tends to favor single-core performance, and as we've seen, Zen 3 is certainly delivering in that regard. But even still, it's quite impressive that the 5600X is reaching a 30% higher score. I've used 7-Zip to test compression and decompression speeds, and Ryzen chips typically do quite well here, especially compared to Intel processors. Zen 3 was still able to offer nice improvements though, with the 5600X scoring 22% faster for decompression and 26% faster in compression. Veracrypt was used to test AES encryption and decryption speeds, and the 5600X was just 10% faster than the 3600 in these tests, so a smaller boost, but still a reasonable win. Microsoft Excel was tested using the Hardware Unboxed Large Number Crunch test, and the 5600X was completing the task 65% faster at stock, then a massive 85% faster with both overclocked, the biggest difference out of everything I've tested. So if you need a spreadsheet machine, Zen 3 could be the way to go. Geekbench was seeing excellent single-core improvements. The 5600X was 27% faster than the 3600, both at stock and when overclocked. The 5600X still had decent improvements in multi-core. The margins just weren't as impressive as the single-core gains, just 14% faster at stock. Here's how the 5600X compares against the older 3600 from last generation, with both processors running at stock in all of the applications just tested. The 5600X is faster in all instances. The single-core improvements are particularly impressive. It's no wonder the 5600X is also beating the Intel competition now. Once both chips are overclocked, the margins actually increase, as the 5600X pulls further ahead of the 3600, and this is because it's simply able to overclock better. This will of course come down to the silicon lottery, and again, it seems that my 3600 isn't a great overclocker. When we look at total system power draw from the wall with the blender test running, the 5600X system is using less power than the 3600 at stock. This is quite impressive when we remember that the 5600X was also completing the blender test 15% faster than the 3600. Once both are overclocked though, the 5600X's power draw shoots up. My 3600 actually uses less power when overclocked compared to stock, as the board seemed to give it more voltage than needed. Higher power draw typically results in more heat, and for the most part, the temperatures align with the power draw graph. The 5600X was running cooler than the 3600 at stock, but yeah, again, once we overclock the 5600X, it's now hotter. These are the clock speeds being reached during these same tests. So at stock, the 5600X was around 400 MHz higher in an all-core workload, and then once overclocked, the 5600X was now 200 MHz higher compared to stock, while the 3600 just had a 100 MHz gain. Let's get into the gaming results next. I've tested 9 games at 1080p, 1440p, and 4K resolutions. Shadow of the Tomb Raider was tested with the game's benchmark tool. The improvement seen at 1080p was the best out of all titles I've tested, with the 5600X reaching a 37% higher average frame rate. Either way though, still a crazy boost just one generation later. There's still a 21% boost at 1440p, then there's no change at 4K. Microsoft Flight Simulator was tested in the Sydney Landing Challenge. The 5600X had a nice leap forward at 1080p, reaching 27% higher average frame rates, and even the 1% lows were above the average FPS from the 3600. It was a similar deal at 1440p too, but then by the time we get up to 4K, the results are basically the same. Zen 3 isn't a silver bullet though. It's no match for Ubisoft's optimizations. Assassin's Creed Odyssey was tested with the game's built-in benchmark tool, and there was a far smaller gap between the two here. At 1080p, the 5600X was 4% higher in average FPS, just a slight lead at all resolutions. Death Stranding was tested by running through the same part of the game on both systems. The 5600X offered huge gains at 1080p, reaching an average FPS 35% higher than the 3600. The 5600X was still able to hit 17% higher frame rates at 1440p. Then again, like the others, basically the same at 4K. Battlefield 5 was tested in campaign mode, and things were much closer together here. Though to be fair to the 5600X, it is being limited by the 200fps frame cap of the game, so its 3% lead probably would have been higher given the 5600X is 5% better at 1440p. I had to put CSGO to the test, as AMD were claiming some big gains with Zen 3, and I was seeing this too. At 1080p, the 5600X X was 37% faster than the 3600 in average frame rate, 19% faster at 1440p, and then at 4K still 13% higher, the largest difference seen at this resolution. Granted, I don't know how many people are playing this one at 4K anyway. Red Dead Redemption 2 was tested with the game's benchmark. Once more, like most of the other titles, the 5600X had a nice boost over the 3600 at 1080p, achieving 25% higher average FPS. It was still 16% faster at 1440p, then basically no change at 4K. Rainbow Six Siege was tested using the game's benchmark with Vulkan. I'm almost getting sick of saying it, but nice improvements with the 5600X at 1080p, which was 24% higher in average FPS, then much lower at higher resolutions, though there were still nice gains to be had in the 1% lows. Far Cry New Dawn was also tested with the game's benchmark and saw similar results. The 5600X was 25% faster in average FPS at 1080p, though the averages still saw nice gains even at higher resolutions, as this test in particular seems more processor dependent than GPU. Over all 9 games tested, the 5600X was 24% faster than the 3600 in average FPS, though this may be held back a little by the 200 FPS frame cap of Battlefield 5, which is why it's below Assassin's Creed Odyssey. In any case, the 5600X was definitely able to offer some excellent gains. Stepping up to 1440p, the 5600X was still 15% faster than the 3600 on average. These gains are far bigger than I was expecting going into this testing, considering the 3600 only launched in July 2019. At 4K, the 5600X is now just 3% faster than the 3600 on average. However, it's being held up by the CSGO outlier. With that removed, the 5600X is 2% faster on average. So basically no difference, as the GPU takes on most of the work. 4K doesn't really make sense to test in a CPU comparison. I just did it to illustrate that if you plan on gaming at higher resolutions, then it might not be worth spending more on the 5600X. And this is why the cost per frame differences are the biggest at 4K. Even at 1080p, the 3600 is technically still offering better value. It's still a capable gaming chip, and it's $100 cheaper. I still think the 5600X is worth considering due to the huge gains on offer. And it's worth considering that these price differences are for the CPU only. The percentage differences become less in the context of, say, a new $1,000 system, for instance. I could see myself upgrading from a 3600 if I wanted a boost, as the improvements from just one generation can be quite large depending on the workload. But if you're on a tighter budget, the 3600 is definitely still capable. Hopefully a 5600X non-X arrives in future at a lower price point. If the difference between the 3600 and 3600X taught us anything, it's that the X doesn't really seem to matter, but it's yet to be seen if that also applies to Zen 3, as AMD have only launched X variants so far. I'm thinking about comparing the 5600X against the 3700X in a future comparison video. Let me know if that's something you would be interested in seeing. And if you're new, then get subscribed for more upcoming processor comparisons like this one.